It's time for another build-up on the channel, and here is another first. There's a lot of firsts because there are thousands upon thousands of model kits out there that I have not built, even though I've got hundreds upon hundreds on this channel already. This is the first time I've even seen a kit like this. It's MPC's Multi Maverick. It's Ohio George Montgomery's altered wheelbase and gasser combination kit. So it says on the box, and we're going to see how well this works when I build it. We're going to see how easy it is to build or how difficult it is to build. We're going to find out, but I'm supposed to be able to change the wheelbase of the front axle forward and back and change out the fenders on the front to move the wheelbase forward and back to build two different models when we're done, either a gasser or an altered wheelbase car. I have no idea how that's gonna work. I have no idea how they plan to do it. It's got some cool vintage box art on there. It's got the art on the top here showing it, saying it's the first combination gasser and altered. And then on the back, it shows stock wheelbase gasser class, modified wheelbase altered class, kind of goes over it, tells you stuff like that. And MPC, being the people that do this stuff, they also had like the change-up kit that I built, where we could change body panels and seats and interiors and all that stuff. We're gonna see how well this has been executed. Reissued by round two models and sent over. On the bottom of the video in the description, I will have links to pre-order as soon as they are available. On the multimedia side of the table, we've got a steel axle in the box. We've got a set of transparent red taillights for the Maverick. We've got a large one-piece window glass, vent glass, windshield, and back glass. Molded crystal clear. No bubbles, no warping. No issues on that from the old molds. Then we have a complete set of tires. One set of tires on this one. It is a drag car. We don't need multiple sets. They are a super awesome looking set of pad printed MH Racemasters. These will sand down very nicely. And then MH Racemaster molded on the opposite side if you did not want the white letters, but it's a dragster. I'm pretty sure they want the sponsors' names to be on the outside. Got a set of skinnies in the front. I do not see a name brand on them, so if there is one, it's well hidden, and a nice tread pattern on there. Those as well will sand down. We've got a decal sheet. It's not big in size, but man, it's got a lot of stuff on there. Everything to replicate the box art. And then what's neat is they kind of slice it here, so you can see with the reflection, those are separate decals, so that when we join the fenders that are supposed to be able to be removed and reattached, we can have their proper logos on there. So we've got everything on there. Chapman, Hal Gillum Ford, all the altered wheelbase stuff, Gasser, Mr. Gasket Company logos. A lot of interesting stuff on that small decal sheet, definitely not too small. And then a massive amount of chrome parts. We all know how much I love gluing chrome parts together. We've got rear suspension, front suspension, axles, radius arms, everything on there. We've got our blower parts, valve covers for the 429 Semi Hemi is the engine under the body in this one. Bumpers, grills. I mean, that is an extensive chrome sheet. Beautiful set of wheels molded open, rear wheels, front wheels. Got a moon tank, steering wheel on this one. Lot of stuff to glue together. Then we switch other sides of the desk. We'll get to our white styrene. First up is the chassis. The chassis on this one, thankfully, some of it is glued together. Guessing this is the front. Got multiple points here. Bracing and attachment points. This has got to be for moving that wheelbase forward and back. I'm guessing we're going to locate some axles or suspension there and there, and all these little holes along the way. It's got little grooves molded in. This is just superfluous casting material that we can remove. So nice looking chassis. Got those hooks in the back. Don't break those off. Moving on. Wheel backs, looks like we got some rear brakes on the car. What else we got over here? Oh, we've got both of our sets of fenders. So we'll have to paint those separate from the body and then attach them. They've got, looks like, bigger pins to hold them in place, hopefully. So we're going to see how well that works. Is it easy? I don't like playing with my cars, so I always end up being kind of ham-fisted and break stuff. We're going to see how fragile that ends up being, how often I break things trying to change stuff on the car. We've got our interior sheet metal for inside the body with the opening for the blower. On this tree here, we've got our dual racing seats, firewall and interior body parts. So yeah, this is all, it's a little intimidating. I'm not sure how I'm going to do it. So I'm definitely going to take my time. We've got our spool in the back end, our differential, bracing, extra big parachute. We've got some linkages. We've got our, well, these are all one piece on this one. So okay, they didn't make it too hard. The zoomies are one piece. We've got our roll cage parts. Looks like steering. Nicely molded open. On this parts tree here, we're missing the other half of the transmission and the other half of the engine block. I have them. They were just loose in the bag. We've got motor mounts, timing cover in the front, and a motor mount as one. Belts. Little drive shaft. Spoiler maybe on the body. Part of the chassis. Got another little drive shaft on there. Small parts tree there, not much on it. And then we move on to the Maverick body. Look at the scoop on that thing. Get a breath of fresh air for sure. Blow dry your hair on the way out. Nice look. Doesn't have door handles molded in. We can see the large attachment points for those fenders. It's going to bother me not gluing stuff together. So we'll see how well those fit, how the body lines go. All cut out for the giant slicks on the back. So that should turn out well. Nice body. It's not too thin, not too thick. Should work well. The side pillars here are not too thin. They won't break easily while we're detailing. I'm going to figure out how I'm going to glue mine together. You can watch me drop parts and glue my fingers to themselves in just a moment. let's take a look-see during the sub-assembly show-off of what I've got assembled and what I will paint and then assemble later. It wasn't as finicky as I thought it was going to be. I was pretty intimidated by that whole front suspension, the wheelie bar, the roll cage, stuff like that, but it actually is turning out to be not so bad. Now, at the end, will it all go together and be able to move pretty easily? No idea. I've already test fit the fenders to the body just by holding them in place, and they do seem to fit quite nicely. And they're not going to be a perfect fit, but it's not bad. I have no idea how they're supposed to hold on after the body is painted and stay there. That I don't know. Do I use some stick-em or chewing gum? I haven't looked in that to see how I'm supposed to get that to stay on there. The body itself doesn't require much assembly aside from the pivot bar in the back. There's two little cutouts where that should go to allow you to line it up properly. I thought these lines here would be for like a firewall or something, and there is something like that in the box and something similar to that on the box art, but there's absolutely no mention of it in the manual at all. When we get to the body parts and the interior, I don't see anything mentioned about putting anything across there. They tell you how to put the fenders on and everything, but I just don't see it. I don't see it in there, so maybe I'm missing it. And I'm going to paint it anyways, just in case I need it, and then I can attach it later. So I've got the roll cage assembled. I put that on the body in its holes, and then it will end up going, when we attach it to the car, the two holes back there will end up slipping around it and going and attaching down. Since the steering and the brake pedal are plastic, I glued them in place. We have all that done, and that will hold rigidly. I use model cement and super glue to get those parts tacked together. With the rear gearbox, I got the brakes on, the wheel mounts, and that all glued together. That will attach to the back of the chassis. The chassis so far, because we're using so many detachable parts, just had the cross member glued on, and that's it. The wheelie bar is all chrome, and that was glued together. The front suspension, the most difficult part of the whole build. Hopefully I've got it all together. Now I'm going to be repainting this anyways, because these parts are molded in white plastic. They did everything else in chrome, and it doesn't look so bad. With a black wash, we'll make it look pretty nice, but since those parts are in white plastic, I'm going to have to paint the whole thing. So I'll just use a chrome spray paint, one of the ones I've tested, and that should attach to the front end of the chassis using the holes as predicted. Those white plastic pieces will slide into that groove, and then the radius arms will come back here and snap into individually. It only changes about a quarter of an inch anyways. But that's how that assembly goes. The instruction manual does help you, sort of, and by sort of, I mean they give you this nice template you saw me using in the assembly process to get all the angles correctly. You're just going to have to find the parts on the parts tree, because they didn't label any of the parts. This is the sequence they want you to assemble it in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Those aren't the part numbers, but there's no other parts that look like these, so you'll be able to get it all taken care of off the parts tree. So we've got those things glued together. I reattached the zoomies to the tree so I can actually get them painted. We got a buttload of chrome stuff. We've got our steering links altered and gasser. We've got our rear trailing arms, valve covers, oil pans, starter, all stuff I'm leaving chrome, tail lights, rear suspension chrome, grill. Part of the grill will get covered with a blackout, and that is on one of the parts trees. It is hiding right here. That will be used, and then we can attach this spoiler to the bottom of the body as well. You can paint it separately or glue it on at your convenience. It's not going to hurt anything sitting like that. So the interior tub requires no assembly. We've got our engine block and engine mounts assembled, and that mounts super far forward. I did not know this, but the engine itself will move depending on the wheelbase. So you'll mount it forward or back. This is all so difficult to do on camera from an angle from the side. but the engine will either mount forward or back, and that's why there's two drive shafts. So there's a lot of delicate stuff. I don't know how that's going to work. I know pretty much I'm going to leave it one way. When I'm done building it, I will try to take part stuff apart and move it for photographs at the end, but I'm not going to be able to do it on camera because I will snap the whole car in half. So that's how that goes. We got our beautiful Semi Hemi, the 429, assembled. I'm going to get all this stuff into paint, get some color on it, and we will begin over there.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
So it's been a little intimidating because I'm kind of worried about how things fit and stuff. The front suspension, the steering arm and all that fits super tight. The steering arm wants to fall out, so I put a little bit of rubber cement in there so that it doesn't continue to fall out every time I try to line things up. We've got the body here. You can see the fenders went on after I let the decals dry. Then we've got our swappable fenders that will go in there. And what actually holds them in place is not only this little clip back here, so don't lose that. Don't let that fall or break off, and don't cut that off when you're working, by all means. That goes into the little hole in here, and then the front piece is held in by the front bumper. So my suggestion when changing body panels is to be very careful when you pry it apart and get it out from behind the bumper and then pull it from the clip. Or you can do it vice versa, but hold the nose in with your finger when you do that, and then you can pull it out like so. And then when you go in, you just reverse it back in. So you can change that wheelbase. It's, you know, a little tricky, and you got to be very careful with it. We can put the other fender on for the other wheelbase and just sort of bend it in place carefully and tuck it behind the fender. And it doesn't look so bad. I mean, you're going to see a seam no matter what. But that's really good engineering for a kit this age to be able to swap parts out like that. I mean, you know, I'm doing it on camera, so I'm kind of leaning funny and all that. And like here, after doing it, I kind of removed some paint right there, so it would always be removed from that section from the back of the bumper. And you can see on this one, little wear mark there. That's going to happen. And these real dragsters had marks all over them, I can promise you, back then. A lot of these guys were self-made men and women, like Shirley Muldowney, and they didn't have the big factory sponsorship where it was a new body every single race and all that stuff and a new vinyl wrap. So the chassis itself, got the zoomies on, put the zoomies on after the engine is installed, got the roll cage on it, got the engine installed. We have the beautiful front end, which turned out really great with that brilliant aluminum paint. And then matches up with the 429. We got our steering wheel in place. We got the rear end in place. Got our wheelie bars on there. Differential and not the spool. All the different suspension components with our red chassis. Looks pretty cool from underneath. We got our drive shaft, which is replaceable. So we've got their swappable steering arm. When we move the wheelbase backwards, we have our drive shaft. When we move the engine backwards, and then you will carefully pry out, and this has to be done, I would do this with tweezers, but you will pry out the radius arms, I think they're called, and these mounts on the frame. You have to also move those, which is not easy, and slide it back into the second holes. And that will allow you then to slide the engine back as well. You can see there's a gap there, and you can bring that engine back all the way to the firewall and use the shorter drive shaft. You can see the shorter drive shaft will install at about that distance, and that's how you can make that work out. But otherwise, it looks awesome as it is. So you've got those parts to watch for, you've got the fenders to watch for, and then this part just holds the body up. We put that on there, and we can hold our body in place when we raise it up. The arm back here, and this is a very, 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 very tight fit to get it to fit around these little hooks, okay? So that's where it's got to go, is around those little hooks, and you will snap that in place, and then you can tilt your body up and display it. Body looks awesome. I've got the decals on there. I'm not worried about touching it now because I've got a coat of floor polish on the whole thing, so I won't rub the decals off. Got our parachute in place. Taillights, you saw me assemble all that stuff. The rear bumper pushes on very nicely, and I used a gel super glue to hold that in place. We're going to get this rock and use that MPC decal on the nose. So I'm going to get the body on the chassis. Then we will do our filming. I've shown you how to remove the fenders. I showed you how to remove the front end. It is very delicate, though, so please be careful. But yeah, now you know how to do that. We're going to drop that on there. It looks awesome. You can see we got our little tachometer in there, pedal shifter, I painted the seats red to kind of match the chassis, all that kind of cool stuff. So I'll put that together. We'll be back for the final. Well, it's final time. The body goes on very easily and sat nice right from the get-go. I mean, it's right down on the wheels and it looks nice as it is. The only thing about final assembly that I don't really care for on this car is how the rear tires, rear wheels attach to the axle. They give you a steel axle that we put in place, but it doesn't extend out either side. It just comes into the brakes and what's supposed to be the wheel mount. So all you have is this little stud. And normally that would work fine on a lot of cars. And I will pull open the manual here and say, and I'm not, you know, obviously when I say that, I'm not trashing the kit or anything. But when you install that metal axle, and you got the brakes here, and you know, you got the inner wheel, and you got this stud, well, this little area here is where the wheel mounts to. Except on this car, it doesn't quite mesh up super well with the inside of the rear wheel. And it means you have to hold it in place while you glue it. And what I ended up doing, I ended up gluing the rear wheel just a little cockeyed, and it's permanently glued on there. I used strong super glue, so it's not going to sit right. From the left side, looks awesome, and that's the side I'm gonna take all my pictures from. The body, you can slide on that rear pin, so you can adjust it if you didn't quite line it up perfectly. But yeah, so just, I'm just gonna say that. Make sure you spend way more time lining that rear wheel up so that it is perfectly straight up and down. I kind of jonked that one. I got the other one straight, and on the other one, I must have been leaning a little bit to my right or something. I don't know, but the car looks awesome. The decals lay down. Final assembly on dragsters is pretty simple because the body just lifts up on and off. So, you know, it's not like it's hard to get on. I love how the decals and everything line up, and they thought out decals for the fenders, and so that you can line them up and cut them off in the right place. Very good job on that. And the expanded decal sheet really makes use of that. And they did a great job determining the size and where that cutoff should be so that it looks good no matter which way you choose. It's a cool concept if you like to mess with your models. At a model show, having this coming out, changing the wheelbase on it and stuff like that could get you, you know, a little trophy or something. People see that the front end comes off, the engine can move, you can display it. You could buy two of these and display it as both so people can see the differences, or you can buy them that way for your shelf and just show them, hey, this is a kit back then designed with older engineering, yet it still works, which sometimes the gimmicks on these models don't work very well at all and they don't look nice. But this one, the fenders fit nice. Obviously the drive shaft, the steering arm are gonna fit just fine as you move the engine back and forth. And it looks pretty cool. So I think it was great. I was intimidated by the kit when I first saw the box and everything it can do, because I'm thinking, all right, this is a dragster. Those parts are super fragile in your front ends. And these ones are, but I built it as one large piece like the manual, used it to line it up, and the lining up worked in the manual. So the little drawing in there is very valuable. Definitely use that. Definitely use that, because it is accurate and it is valuable. And it does help you make sure that when you snap your front end into place, you will have that. Now, I prefer this version of the car, so I'm gonna be leaving mine as that. But if you like to do the different versions, you go ahead and do it. I think the kit is pretty cool. And kits like this, the originals go for quite a bit of money because they're kind of rare. Now it's been reissued, which is awesome for people like me that wanna build a kit as well as collect kits sometimes. But then you can also build one of the newer versions and save yourself a lot of coin. I want to thank Round 2 Models for sending this little beauty over. This was way more fun than I imagined it would be. And that's what I always suggest on the show is give something a shot. Just because you think it might not be as cool as you think, maybe it will be. And this one was better than I thought, and it worked better than I thought. So I was pleasantly surprised. As always, thanks for watching the workshop. I'll see all of you at the next review.